Pornography is not a universal term. It is a word unique to our society, and more specifically to a Christian society. My best attempts to translate it to friends in Cambodia, for instance, have been difficult to say the least. The best I've come up with? Oh, it's when you look at something that you're not supposed to be looking at, I would say. My first experience with looking at what I was not supposed to be looking at was, as with most boys growing up, the Playboy magazine at the drugstore. I was shocked to notice primordial arousal from imagery. I suddenly was coveting imagery that was surprisingly frowned upon by the elders. Previous to that, there was subtle but innocuous sexual references on television and comic books, like Betty and Veronica, or Uhura on Star Trek, Pam Dauber, Mindy from Mort and Mindy, and Supergirl. Why do we look down on or have prejudices to something as basic and wonderful as sexual desire through imagery? Are not my foreign friends right in simply questioning why we in the West are brought up believing that to look is wrong? Freud would agree. He saw a good many of our societal neuroses as sexually based. And Jung, taking it a step further, uncovered Christianity as a culprit to our quirky hang-ups. But don't get me wrong, I don't think scientifically based images of genitalia, blatant intercourse, the bizarre, or the kinky is fundamentally at the root of imaginal desire. It is rather instinct, and to satisfy you culturalists out there, instinctual love of beauty.
Life is so strange when you don't know how to take where you're going to. You can't be sure of any situation. Some people change the way you want to.
Pornography has always been around, but now it's a widespread crisis. Many counselors are warning this addiction is an epidemic. Why? Blame the internet. Pornography is only a click away. Roughly 40 million Americans regularly visit porn websites. This is no longer someone else's problem. Pornography has invaded the hearts and homes of your family, your friends, and most likely your church.
Now, pornography, whether it's a magazine or TV or the internet, is specifically designed to help feed your lustful thoughts as a man. Pornography not only encourages people to create an image in their mind, but it also entices them to fantasize about it. Now, usually these fantasies involve an erotic act that can only ultimately be satisfied with someone else or by masturbation.
After we got married, I proceeded to find out that my husband was very enslaved into pornography. I didn't really think much of it, kind of thought it was a normal guy thing. I was kind of naive about it. And things just kind of kept getting worse and worse. I would find pornographic magazines in the bathroom or in the bedroom. He started to want to get me involved in that also. And I was like, no way, no how. It's kind of dirty. It's there.
Now, the word pornography comes from the Greek words porno and graphia. Now, it means the depiction of the activity of whores.